between the pages of books is a lovely place to be. Hi guys, this is Mansi Singh from Readers and Creators. In this video, we will talk about different type of book formats. We read newspapers, magazines, short articles in the form they are. But when it comes to reading book of more than 200 to 300 pages, we would prefer a format which is easy to handle, portable, comes with fine form size, and most importantly, look pretty on our shelves. Book industry make different type of book formats which attract readers with their certain specific qualities. Every other person have a specific choice of book formats. Some like paperback, some like hardback, some like ebooks, some like audiobooks. It's all about their choices. Now the first in that list is hardcover or hardback, which are generally known as trade cloth in book industry. Now a great fact about hardcovers is they didn't exist before World War II. Before World War II, people used to read through large scrolls. Only after World War II came the first trimmed size of hardcover copy. The greatest quality of a hardback is they look pretty on bookshelves. Bookstores generally own hardcovers because the title is easily noticeable by customers. Hardbacks' life are short if not protected or covered properly. They are so delicate that they need to be protected like a kid or a pet. They are easy to read if you are sitting on a table or chair or just wanted to read a copy for a few minutes. But for a long time, they are not great to handle. They come with removable dust jackets inside which exists a much more pretty hard binding. Some hardbacks come in library binding form, which are only for extensive use and are rarely available to common people like us. Second in the list is paperback or standard paperbacks. Paperbacks are widely read and widely loved. The most important quality of paperbacks are they are portable. We can read it while sitting, laying, standing, in a crowd, alone, or anywhere. We can carry that paperback along with us anywhere we go. Paperbacks take less space in shelves and we can arrange large number of books in a limited space. Their spine are so great that we can even fold it over if we want. I abhor that, but some people do that while reading, which is a wrong thing because books get hurt, dude. And the dimensions are from 5 to 8 inches. Third in the category is mass market paperback or pocketbooks. And as the name suggests, pocketbooks, they are easy to take anywhere you want and they are just 4 inches wide and 7 inches high. But the paper quality is not as pretty as standard paperbacks. They are printed generally on pulp or newspaper print type paper. And also the fonts are so tiny that people like me who have a eyesight problem should not read mass market paperbacks. Now, mass market paperbacks are widely written for romance, science fiction and mystery thrillers. They are easy to read under a blanket, in a corner of your house, and in a bus, in a metro, or anywhere. You can just put it in your handbag and carry it with you anywhere you go. The size is generally like this. Next come the audiobooks. Now, some people are so engaged in their professional and personal life and don't have the circumstances to read a 500-page novel, which they have awaited for so long. So audiobooks comes as a savior for them. Audiobooks comes in two forms, unbridged version and bridged version. Unbridged version is simply a person narrating the whole book line by line and then it comes in an audio form. But bridged version is an edited, shortened or a refined version of a book written at the first place. Author can either deny it or accept it and then only then after it comes into circulation. Audiobooks are best when you want to gain more in less time. Next are oversized books or massive hardbacks, where we can see them in photography books, cookbooks and art books, and rarely in graphic novels. Oversized books must be read properly while sitting on a chair and reading it on a table. They come at a very expensive price. Their paper quality is so fine. Next are ebooks. Ebooks come at zero physical cost with no burden of storing it and transferring it. I don't like personally ebooks because all the reasons for which books are hyped, the fragrance, the ink smell, the font size, the colored pages, everything, that all is missing in an ebook. But the best thing about ebook is we can read wherever we want to, and if I want to read a particular book right now at this present moment, I can't just go to a bookstore and purchase that book in next 5 minutes, but I can certainly have an ebook version of that book in my phone right now by buying it. We can read it on laptop, tablet, phone. The best thing about an ebook is we can read it in the dark. So yeah, that's it guys. So what are you gonna read next or buy next? A hardback or a paperback or an oversized book? Oversized books we can't generally afford at this age. So that's it, and we will discuss something else in our next video. Till then, be happy, keep reading. Bye bye.